Hi, welcome to EPG Pathshala Spanish. We are in the paper entitled Advanced Spanish Grammar. I am Gaurav Kumar and I teach Spanish in the Center of Spanish, Portuguese, Italian and Latin American Studies in Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi. The title of this module is Repaso 4 and we shall further strengthen our concepts of the prepositions and exclamatory covering other earlier modules with further practice of related exercises and an encapsulated revision. There are different ways of talking about a moment in time according to days, months, years, hours, etc. The preposition a can be used. All prepositions in the section will answer to the question when. Let us start with the first preposition as en. En is used with years, months, seasons and specific times. Let us take some examples. Ningún equipo pudo marcar un gol en la prórroga del partido. No team was able to do a goal in the extra time of the match. Some compound prepositions also starting with en refer to specific times. En pleno plus noun refers to a key or most intense moment of something. The adjective pleno agrees with the noun that precedes it. En pleno mes de diciembre, no conseguirás ni una habitación libre en Goa. In the middle of December, you will not get any room available in Goa. En tiempos de guerra, incluso la gente común debe de estar dispuesto a servir al país. In the times of war, even common people ought to be ready to serve the country. Some expressions of en with particular time of the day, día, tarde, noche, madrugada, are incorrect, but one can hear them being used in the media. En la noche de ayer is incorrect, and one should not say ayer por la noche. En la noche de ayer is incorrect, and one should say ayer por la noche or anoche. The preposition a. The preposition a is used for telling the noun as referring to the age and with time of the day. With r. ¿A qué hora empieza la película? A las cinco y cuarto. At what time does the movie start? At quarter past five. With age, a tus años, yo ya daba 10 vueltas del campo. At your age, I used to do 10 rounds of the ground. A principios de or a finales de la semana, mes, año or siglo means at the beginning or end of the week, month, year, or century. A mediados de semana, mes, año, siglo. This means in mid of the week, month, year, or century. A medianoche, medianoche, or a mediodía means at noon and at midnight, respectively. Durante is a preposition which can be used in the following sentence format. En mi opinión, durante las vacaciones no se debe hablar de trabajo. In my opinion, during vacations, one must not talk of work. Durante la manifestación, todos estuvimos unidos. During the protest, we were all united. Singular nouns preceded by the definite article refers to days, weeks, months, years. El lunes, el martes, el domingo, el día de Navidad, el día de mi cumpleaños. In English, equivalents are on Monday, on Tuesday, on Sunday, on Christmas Day, on the day of my birthday. Plural definite article plus day of the week indicates repetition. Los lunes voy a la clase de yoga. Mondays I go to yoga class. Es una pena que trabajemos los domingos también. It's a shame that we work on Sundays as well. It is important to note that the expression de día means when there is sunlight and de noche means when there is no sunlight. They cannot be combined with adverbs like hoy, mañana, ayer, etc. and should not be confused with the previous expressions of this section. The other format with the preposition entre is that of entre plus noun plus e plus noun, which also refers to a period of time indicating two moments. El profesor estará en su despacho entre las tres y las cinco. The professor will be in his office between 3 to 5. Los partidos de la liga serán entre el 10 y 30 de enero. The league matches will be from 10th to 30th January. A lo largo de is a compound preposition that expresses a process. A lo largo de este curso, vamos a estudiar varios temas de la gramática española. Throughout this course, we are going to study several topics of grammar. In case of the preposition después de and tras followed by noun, it provides information of an event that precedes the action of the main verb in the main clause. Tras muchas consultas con muchos médicos, ellos decidieron optar por el tratamiento natural. After many consultations with many doctors, they decided to opt for natural treatment. Iré a verte después del partido del cricket. I will see you after the cricket match. In the sense of the future, let us see the preposition dentro de plus period of time. Dentro de 5 años ya seré rico. Within 5 years I'll be rich. De aquí plus period of time has the same meaning of future as the earlier expression. El tren llegará de aquí a media hora. In half an hour the train will arrive. The gerund can also be utilized to express the simultaneity of two actions. Asistiendo las clases de música, conocí a mi media naranja. Attending the music classes, I met my soulmate. Viendo la película, escribía la carta también. Watching television, he was writing the letter also. Approximation. The idea of approximation in Spanish is expressed in different ways depending on the context. To talk about numbers as in an estimate or approximately, the possible structures are cerca de, alrededor de, and cosa de. Also, with indefinite articles unos and unas can express an estimate. Te lo dije unas 20 veces. I told you 20 times. Han venido unas 2,000 personas al concierto. Some 2,000 people have come to the concert. Next is hacia, a eso de, and sobre, which are prepositions that can express approximation in the sense of time. Ayer volví del trabajo hacia las 5:30 de la tarde. Yesterday, I returned home from work towards 5:30 p.m. The next set of prepositions indicate the means or instrument with which something is done. The preposition a is used with certain fixed expressions such as escribir a máquina, which means typing, escribir a lápiz, writing with a pencil, ir a pie, to walk, ir a caballo, ride a horse, ir a nado, go swimming, lavar a mano, hand washed, lavar a máquina, machine washed. The preposition en is related to transportation. Ir en bicicleta, to go cycling. Ir en avión, to go by plane. Ir en coche, to go by car. If the medium is a person, that is an intermediary, then por is used. Me he enterado de la noticia por Ana. I came to know about the news from Ana. Ella ha conseguido el puesto por su tío. She has got the post due to her uncle. To express frequency, the preposition a can express frequency and normally it follows an amount. El guardia gana 10,000 rupias al mes. The guard earns 10,000 rupees monthly. A la semana means weekly. Al año is yearly. Al día is daily. For the plural of every two or more meses, semanas, preposition cada is used. Cada tres meses manda dinero a su familia. Every 3 months he sends money to his family. In order to express the temperature, we can say it in the following manner. Son 7 grados bajo cero. It is minus 7 degrees. El termómetro marca 10 sobre cero. The thermometer reads 10 degrees above zero. Depende de and según are synonymous expressions. They refer to variations that can occur in something as per circumstance. Una camisa de pura seda puede costar de 1,000. Una camisa de pura seda puede costar de 5,000 a 8,000 rupias. Depende de la tienda. A pure silk shirt can cost from 5 to 8,000 rupees depending on the shop. A partir de marks the beginning of an event. A partir de julio, los días serán más cortos. Starting July, the days will be shorter. El partido empieza a partir de las 5 de la tarde. The match starts from 5 p.m. You may have heard the sentence as estaban en ca de su madre. Ca means en casa de. It can also mean to the house of. Fuimos ca nuestra madre. Fuimos a casa de nuestra madre. We went to our mother's house. Also, it's possible to hear fui a ca mi madre. Bajo is a formal preposition. It is used as a reference to space and some legal expressions. Lo detuvieron bajo la acusación de asesinato. They arrested him on charges of murder. Estás bajo sospecha. You are under suspicion. Let's revise now the case of nominalization. To nominalize is to convert a part of the sentence in a noun or name. The most widespread form of using grammatical categories as nouns is through an article or another determiner. The case of infinitive as noun. Nadar es el mejor deporte para adelgazarse. Swimming is the best sport in order to get slim. El beber mucho puede conducir a la intoxicación e incluso a la muerte. Drinking can lead to poisoning and even death. As object, let us see some examples. Es prohibido pitar en la calle porque causa mucha contaminación de sonido. Honking is prohibited on the streets because it causes a lot of noise pollution. No me gusta cocinar. I don't like to cook. Literally, the sentence will be translated as cooking doesn't please me. Nominalization with low definite neutral article. Low never defines nouns because in Spanish there are no neutral nouns. Low itself is used to substitute parts of speech. Lo principal es que no os hayáis hecho daño. La cosa más importante es que no os hayáis hecho daño. The main thing is that you all have not got hurt. The most important thing is that you have not hurt yourself. Low plus possessive adjectives has the same meaning as low plus adjective. Lo nuestro es vuestro. That is to say, nuestras cosas son también vuestras. In English, what is ours is yours. Or we can also say, our things are also yours. Another example, no toques lo mío. Or it is the same as saying, no toques mis cosas. In English, don't touch what is mine. Or don't touch my stuff. Lo plus comparatives also mean the same as lo plus adjective. Lo mejor para el dolor de cabeza es un analgésico. Best for headache is a painkiller. Lo plus que introduces a relative clause and it can be substituted by la cosa que. Lo que me gusta más de ti es tu sinceridad. La cosa que más me gusta es tu sinceridad. What I like most about you is your honesty. The thing I like most is your honesty. Nominalization with el, la, los, las. In this case, there is always a noun that is omitted and the context indicates which noun it is. El gordo es más flaco. I repeat. El gordo es más listo que el flaco. Here, the noun is missing. For example, it could have been said, el ratón gordo es más listo que el ratón flaco. In English, the fat one is smarter than the skinny. Or, the fat mouse is smarter than the skinny mouse. El, la, los, las plus de plus noun has a parallel value to that of the previous section. In this case, the noun complements the el, la, los, las plus de plus noun expresses a quality as an adjective. Yo prefiero el de rayas azules. I prefer the one with blue stripes. El, la, los, las plus que plus adjectival clause, sentence refers to the person or thing. El que no esté en la reunión no podrá opinar is the same as saying las personas que no estén en la reunión no podrán opinar. In English, those not in the meeting cannot comment, or people who are not in the meeting cannot comment. Demonstrative adjective plus el, la, los, las plus possessive adjectives. Este es el mío. Aquel es el tuyo. This is mine. Is that yours? With adverbs, ni el ayer, ni el mañana. Es solo el hoy que tenemos por cierto. Nor yesterday, nor tomorrow. It's today, that is for sure. Solo importan el aquí y el ahora. The only thing that matters is right here, right now. Let us now revise the exclamatory sentences. One of the easiest ways to convey a very strong feeling or opinion about something is to use an exclamatory word. These words are very similar to interrogative words, but instead of asking a question, they simply state an idea or opinion. Exclamatory words make a simple phrase into a statement of surprise or amazement. The specific word used in a Spanish exclamation depends on the word that follows. Notice that all exclamatory words carry an orthographic accent, just like interrogative words. To make judgments about the characteristics of someone or something, or on the way of doing something or a situation, and to intensify qualities, sensations, or feelings, the following constructs are used. Cuál, used in literary works and not common in day-to-day speech. Cuál can be used to replace qué. Cuán feliz me haces. How happy you make me. Cuán maleducados son. How rude they are. Cuánto, used in front of nouns to express surprise at an amount, and in front of verbs to express surprise at how much someone is doing the action of that verb. To modify a noun, cuánto must match the noun in gender and number. To modify a verb, use the singular masculine form cuánto. ¿Cuánto dinero tiene Bill Gates? How much money Bill Gates has? ¿Cuántas bendiciones tenemos? How many blessings we have? ¿Qué? ¿Qué is used in front of nouns, adjectives, and adverbs to mean how or water? ¿Qué plus adjective plus verb? ¿Qué músico es? What a musician he is. ¿Qué inteligentes son? How smart they are, or they are so smart. ¿Qué plus noun? ¿Qué hombre? What a man. ¿Qué plus noun plus mas plus adjective? ¿Qué casa más grande? What a big house. ¿Qué plus noun plus tan plus adjective? ¿Qué mujer tan guapa? What a beautiful woman. When an adjective is not used, the exclamation may indicate positive or negative aspects, depending on context and intonation. ¿Qué casa? ¿Es una casa maravillosa, extraña o desastrosa? What house? It's a wonderful, strange or disastrous house. ¿Qué sueño he tenido? ¿He tenido un sueño extraño, desagradable o maravilloso? What a dream I had. I had a strange, unpleasant or wonderful dream. ¿Quién is used with verbs like pensar, suponer, sospechar, imaginar, to express surprise at some unexpected event or situation? ¿Quién iba a pensar que Lourdes estaba deprimida? Who would have thought that Lourdes was depressed? ¿Quién iba a pensar que Ana se divorciaría? Who would have thought that Ana would divorce? ¿Quién is also used to express wishes? ¿Quién plus imperfect subjunctive? ¿Quién cocinará como tú? Yo soy un desastre en la cocina. Who could cook like you? I am a disaster at cooking. ¿Quién plus pudiera plus infinitive? ¿Quién pudiera viajar como tú? Me gustaría conocer África. Who could travel like you? I'd like to know Africa. To make judgments intensify and express different emotions like alegría, joy, sorpresa, surprise, admiración, admiration, desagrado, disgust, you can use the following constructions with qué or cuánto, cuánta, cuántos, cuántas. Qué de plus singular or plural noun. Qué horror. Qué de niños, which means muchos niños. What a horror. So many kids. Qué de plus noun plus gerund to indicate a lot of people doing the activity described by the gerund. Que plus poco, poca, pocos, pocas, plus singular or plural noun, plus the verb, plus subject. Que pocos alumnos hay, phenomenal. How few students are there, great. Que plus poco, plus verbo sujeto, is to refer to actions. Que plus poco plus verb refers to actions. Que poco come Cristina. Así está de delgada. How less Cristina eats. That is why she is thin. To intensify action or express feelings of surprise, admiration, disgust, etc., to the way of doing something, you can use the following constructions with como. Como plus verb plus the subject. Como canta esa mujer? How that woman sings. Como nevaba? How much it was snowing. In many cases, the exact meaning of exclamation depends on context and intonation of the speaker. ¿Cómo canta María? Tiene una voz preciosa. ¿Qué bien canta María? How Maria sings. She has a beautiful voice. Maria sings well. ¿Cómo canta María? Es la que más desafina del coro. ¡Qué mal canta María! How Maria sings. She's the one who is most out of tune from the choir. How bad Maria sings. In order to clarify the positive or negative aspects, you can use the following structure. Como plus verb plus de bien or de mal plus the subject. Como canta de mal María or qué mal canta María. How bad Maria sings. To express disagreement with an earlier information, the following construction is used with K. The information can refer to the present, past, or future. K plus present indicative of ir plus a plus infinitive plus the subject. Let us see an example. Isabella es encantadora. ¿Qué va a ser encantadora? Si es un horror. Isabella is lovely. Isabella being lovely? She is a horror. El director pagó la comida. ¿Qué va a pagar la comida el director? La pagó la empresa. The director paid for the meal. The director paying the bill. The company paid for it. To emphasize a quality, you can use the following construction. Como plus ser plus de plus adjective. Como es de alto tu amigo. How tall is your friend? To express feelings of weariness, impatience, or irritation to an event or situation, cuando is used. ¿Desde cuándo decides tú quién puede venir a casa? Since when do you decide who can come home? Let us see some more examples. ¿Qué de ruido? How noisy. ¿Qué de gente corriendo? So many people running. ¿Qué de comida habéis comprado? How much food you all have bought? ¿Cómo era de generosa mi abuela? How generous was my grandma? ¿Cómo es de guapo tu hermano? How handsome is your brother? ¿Dónde está el chalet de Luis? What a place is Luis' chalet in? To express a feeling of surprise, admiration, disgust, etc. for a place, ¿dónde and a dónde are used? ¿Dónde vive Marta? Es un barrio precioso. What a place Marta lives. It's a beautiful neighborhood. ¿A dónde nos envió Paco? Es un sitio horrible. Where has Paco sent us? It's a horrible place. ¿Qué poco estudia Rebecca? How little Rebecca studies. Other examples are, ¿qué pocos corredores que hubo el año pasado en la maratón? How few runners were there the last year in the marathon? ¿Qué poco ha llovido este año? How little it has rained this year? ¿Qué pocos pasajeros hay en este vuelo? How few passengers are there in this flight? ¿Qué pocas ganas tengo de trabajar? How little interest I have in working? ¿Cómo cantan de mal tus alumnos? How bad your students sing? ¿Cómo son de tontas tus amigas? How foolish are your friends? ¿A dónde nos envió Paco? Es un sitio horrible. Where has Paco sent us? It's a horrible place. ¿Qué poco estudia Rebecca? How little Rebecca studies? ¿Cómo era de rara esa chica? How strange was that girl? ¿Dónde duerme Paco? Huele mal. What a place Paco sleeps. it smells bad. ¿Dónde aparcó Selena? Where has she parked? ¿Hasta cuándo vas a dejar los videojuegos? Till when will you stop playing video games? The prepositions and exclamatory forms are crucial part of any language system, and a good control can be achieved over them with more practice. Hope the modules added to your existing knowledge of these words in Spanish, as we have discussed examples particular to the native level of language use. Thank you. Gracias.